Who won the fight this weekend? Triple G and Dominic, whatever.
Chivachenko, whatever, yeah. It was close. It could have gone either way. I thought the commentators was on the other guy's side, though. Divachenko.
So you think they gave him too much credit?
Yeah, but like, I think Triple G landed the harder, cleaner punches, but Triple G definitely got outworked.
Okay.
It was close.
Sorry about that. How about you?
You know, Badu and I was talking about it earlier today, and we felt like both guys fought really hard, gave a great effort. But, of course, Triple G came out on top. I didn't get to see all the details of the fight, but it looked like his opponent did really well. So it's hard for me to say who actually won, but I will say his opponent gave a legitimate effort. So he deserved some kind of credit for that.
Hey, we missed you last week.
What school you went to?
Texas A&M University.
I can tell. I know you went to goddamn college. Where you talking?
Yeah, Texas A&M.
Last week's question, who won between Sean Porter and Errol Spence?
That's an easier one if you ask me. I felt like Sean Porter won that fight. I felt like he'd done the things necessary to win that fight. But, of course, the knockdown in the 11th round, which wasn't much of a knockdown, but I have to get my hands off to Spence for the work he did. But I felt even with the knockdown, we walk away with a draw. Evidently, the judges didn't see it the same way. We don't get an opportunity to decide who the judges are. So we take the loss the way it is. We run to the next opportunity. Hopefully, Errol will get back in the ring with us. We would love for that to happen. But if you're asking me, Sean Porter won that fight.
See, it was Texas A&M. If it was University of Texas, he'd be a little more articulate.
Earl from Texas too, right?
Yeah, Earl from Texas.
The one I was at? Triple G.
Yeah.
Triple G. I thought it was a close fight. I wouldn't have been disappointed with the draw. But I think that, Triple G, you look at the faces, one compared to the other.
I didn't see the fight. So
it was a lot of it was based on damage, but it was a hell of a fight, boy. You know, did a Yachenko, whatever, Sergey? Yeah, he's up and coming, man, and he's going to be in the mix big time. But he did a great job. It's a good fight, man. People are talking about maybe candidate fight of the year type of thing, but two good fighters.
All right.
Two good fighters.
So you're asking me about the fight. Didn't even see it, bro.
No, but this is my job.
Oh, okay. Fair enough. Touche.
What about people that say that the other guy won?
Oh, man, how many times have we heard that, right?
Yeah, we've heard it time.
The official thing is what the judges gave it, and unanimous decision, 1 or 2 points. But that knockdown helped.
we did this shit earlier today.
It's been so long. I haven't been on the Mayweather channel. I've been out traveling the world, starting promotional companies and shit. He forgot the question. He has a question for so long.
Yeah, no. We had a radio show about this shit earlier.
That too.
Okay. Who you thought won the fight this weekend? Triple G or
I thought Sergey the Rev Yanchenko won the fight. Yeah, I know you guys surprised I could pronounce that name. He won the fight. He controlled the pace. He threw combinations. He outworked Triple G. He showed better range generalship by making Triple G go from corner to corner. The body shots were classic and epic. I was very shocked because you guys all know I'm a huge Triple G fan, but he lost the fight for sure. When the cut happened, I was really worried that they were going to stop the fight because the referee didn't realize that cut was caused by a punch, and I thought they would have stopped the fight early. Sergey definitely would have won, unlike the scorecards were reading. Sergey won the fight for sure. It's a really sad thing that a guy fights his heart out and can't get a victory, but that's boxing. It's a business disguised as a sport, like Amir would say.
Nice shout out, Amir. Okay, you introduce the people to who you are.
Tim Zhu from Australia, 14-0. No, I'm down.
You come from a boxing family?
Yeah, I come from a boxing family. My dad was an undisputed world champion, so, you know. Yeah.
Man, interview this dude. His daddy beat my brother. Okay. All right. Okay, did you see the Triple G fight?
Yeah, I did. I did watch it.
Okay, who did you thought won?
Ooh, I thought Triple G won it, but I think the knockdown is what gave him the slight victory.
Yeah, okay.
But it was close, very close.
Okay. You said Triple G. Okay. Did you see the fight? Zary? Triple G?
Yeah, the fight was a tough fight for Triple G.
Okay, who you thought won?
To make it fair, I've been a draw at least. You know, that knockdown, you know, kind of favored a little bit in Triple G, but it was a close fight, I would say. But Triple G, you know, he's getting up there now. You know, young guys are coming up now. Mm-hmm.
he said it was a good fight. You thought Triple G won or was it a draw?
I'll give it a draw, you know, to make it fair a little bit.
A draw, man.
Yeah.
Who you thought won?
I thought the other guy won. His name, Devchenko?
Yeah, Devchenko. Yeah, he got the name right, everything.
Yeah, I thought he won. Okay. It was a close fight, but I thought he did enough. He pressed action a little bit more than Triple G did, and I think that's what got him the victory.
Right. Yeah, the other guy won.